So that's not doing very well. Maybe if you were really clever, you could do better. And Stan Wagon and Rob Pratt came up with a lower bound, a lower bound that shows you that you can at least do moderately well in general. And here's their construction. They have an explicit construction that works pretty well. So we're given n, and then we pick an m, typically square root of n, that kind of size. So take the numbers m minus n, and, you know, think of n as being 50 or something. So m minus n is a rather large negative number. M is going to be a small positive number. M minus n, and then go up by 2s. M minus n plus 2, m minus n plus 4, and we want to go to n numbers. So the last number is going to be n minus n plus twice n minus 1. In other words, m plus n minus 2. So we go from m minus n up to m plus n minus 2 in steps of 2. And if you do that, and you pick m to be about square root of n, you do pretty well. Their example was, if n is a power of 4, nice number, take m to be 1 plus square root of n, so 1 plus 2 to the k. And if you do that, so now we've got a concrete set of numbers, those numbers. What you get for the number of powers of 2 is n times k minus n over 2 plus 3 halves square root of n. And basically, it's n times k, which is, now k is the log of n to the base 4, so it's approximately n times log of n to the base 4, n times k. Okay, so that's a lower bound of order n log n. Theoretically, we could get n choose 2 if we were really clever. So it seems to me quite likely that some more cleverer, explicit construction will do better than n log n. But no one has found one. And in particular, if you have four numbers, A, B, C, D, show you can't get 5 powers of 2 from A plus B, A plus C, A plus D, B plus C, B plus D, C plus D. Six numbers. Can you get 5 powers of 2? No one knows.
So k can't have a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4,
it could
a 5.
It could have a 1. It could be all 1s. Ah. Or it could have a 5 in the middle of it.